In today's video, you will learn how to transfer data from Android to iPhone using three simple methods. With these three methods, you can transfer your photos, videos, music, and everything else from your Android phone to your iPhone with and without using a computer, and that is coming up. Our first method is using a data transfer software. For this method to work, you need a Windows or a Mac computer, and after that you need a data transfer software called Phone Trans. You can get it from the link given in the video description below. So just click on this blue button and install the software into your Windows or Mac computer. After installing, open it up. Once open, this is the interface. With this software, you can also backup and restore your phones. In order to transfer files from Android to iPhone, click on phone to phone option, then select quick transfer and click on this blue button. Next, connect both your phones to computer using your USB cable. After connecting your Android phone, you have to install an app. The app is called Phone Trans. I don't know why this app is blacklisted by Google Play Protect. So just install this app, tap on install anyway, and give all the required permissions. After that, you will see the screen. Now leave your Android phone as it is. And on your computer, both of your devices will be connected. As you can see on the left hand side, you have the source phone. This is the phone that will transfer the data, and target device will receive the data. So in my case, I am going to transfer data from Android to iPhone. So I am going to click on switch, which will change the order. Now all you have to do is click on transfer. After that, wait for the software to load data from your Android phone. This process takes barely a few minutes. Once your files are loaded, select them all and click on this blue button. And now wait for this transferring process to complete. This process will take time depending on how much data you are transferring. So in this case, this process will take a while because I have more than 100 GB of file on my Android phone. Once the transferring process is completed, you will see this message. Just click on OK and close the software because your job is done. And on the other side, check your phone if your selected data are transferred or not. As you can see, these are the exact same photos that I had on my Android phone. Now they are all transferred to my iPhone. And also, one of the best thing about the software is, if you transfer your music, the music will be stored inside Apple Music app. As you can see. Alright, now let me show you the second method. Our second method is using Move to iOS app. For this method to work, you don't need a computer, but there are some requirements. Number one, your both phones must be connected to the same Wi-Fi network. Number two, you have to erase your iPhone in order to transfer data from your Android phone. And number three, this is not a requirement, by the way, this is a warning. This process takes very long time, especially if you have too much data on your Android phone. If you meet these requirements, then this method will work. If not, then you can try the first method or the last method depending on your preferences. Now let me show you how this method works. Alright, first of all, erase your iPhone by going to settings, go to general, scroll all the way down, select transfer or reset iPhone, tap on erase all content and settings, tap continue, select erase iPhone, type your iPhone passcode, tap your Apple ID password to sign out. After that, wait for your iPhone to restart. Once your iPhone is restarted, just swipe up and go through the setup process. While setting up your iPhone, when you come to this page where it says transfer your apps and data, and there you will have a lot of options. And from these options, select from Android, tap continue. Now on your Android phone, open Play Store and search for Move to iOS app. Install this app on your Android phone. Once installed, open it and go through agreement and this permission process. Okay, now all you have to do is type this verification code on your Android phone. After that, your phone will be connected with each other. Now select the type of files that you want to transfer to your iPhone. So in my case, I'm gonna select everything except this photo library because it's 41 gigabytes and it will take a lot of time. In your case, you can select anything from these options. Alright, after that, just tap on continue and wait for this transferring process to complete. This process will take time depending on how much data you are transferring. While this process is taking place, would you please like this video and subscribe to my channel? For you, like and subscribe is just a matter of clicks, but for me, it means a world. So thank you so much if you do. Once the transferring process is completed on your Android phone, tap on done. And now you can close your Android phone. You no longer need it. Now on your iPhone, just continue setting up your phone. Once the setup process is completed, now see if your selected data are transferred or not. So let's start with contacts. So as you can see, these are the exact same contacts and call logs that I have on my Android phone. Now they are all transferred to my iPhone. And also let's go to messages. As you can see, these are the messages that I had on my Android phone. Our third and last method is using a USB drive to transfer data from Android to iPhone. For this method to work, you don't need a computer. All you need is this USB drive called SanDisk Ultra. You can get yours from the link given in the video description below. One side of the pen drive is USB-C and the other side is USB-A. In order to transfer data using this pen drive, first of all, connect it to your Android phone like so. When it's connected, the files app will open up by itself. If it doesn't open up by itself, then just open the files app manually. Alright, now go to your phone storage and select the type of files that you want to transfer to your iPhone. So in my case, I'm going to transfer some photos and videos. Just select your files by tapping and holding. After selecting your files, tap on these three dots, select copy. From here, select your USB drive. You can either paste those photos inside the USB drive directly, or you can create a new folder by tapping on this create button. Name your folder. So let's say I want to call the folder 2025. Next, tap on OK and paste your selected data by tapping on this blue button. Once your files are copied, now you can eject USB from your Android phone and connect it to your iPhone. Just like this. In order to use this pen drive with your iPhone, all you need is this files app. Okay, so just open the files app after connecting USB drive. If you click on browse, now go back, there you will see your USB drive. In my case, it's called untitled. In your case, it will be your USB drive name. So just open it and select the folders that contains the files that you want to transfer. So in my case, I have some photos and videos inside this folder. So just select them by tapping on these three dots. Tap on select. After selecting your files, tap on the share option. Scroll down and select save. After that, wait for a few seconds. Now this transferring process will take time. The transferring process is happening in the background. Once the transferring process is completed, this selection will be deselected automatically by themselves. Okay, now you can see now all these files got deselected. That means these photos and videos should be saved on my photos app. So let's see. As you can see, these are the photos and videos that I just transferred from my Android phone to my iPhone using this USB drive. And now you can disconnect your USB drive and transfer it to any device that uses USB-C or USB-A port. So there you have it, guys. That is my video on how to transfer data from Android to iPhone. Please let me know which one of these options were helpful to you. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I would love to hear them. And also, if you learned something new from this video, then please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Your one like and share means a world to me. So thank you so much if you do. And if you want more videos like this in the future, then please subscribe to my channel. And I will catch you on the next one. Stay blessed. Stay safe. Bye.